as part of what you were talking about in terms of what you do, you oversee a lot of things and a lot of people. You know, and a lot of times in leadership, we talk about, you know, how we lead our folks. And you mentioned that not everybody is motivated by the same things. But I wanted to kind of talk about two specific groups, if we could, just for a second, in terms of, you know, maybe how you approach them from a leadership standpoint. And that's full-time folks, people that are there full-time versus part-time. Are there different things, different tactics that you use to manage, you know, those two groups a little differently?
So I think that, sure, yes, the answer to your question would be yes. So we have, like I said, it's a pretty large department. In our recreation division alone, we're working with upwards of 65 full-time employees throughout our various areas in the department. Then, like I mentioned, our part-time, you know, complement is also pretty large. And there are different ways to lead those types of groups. You know, I think that the first obvious thing would be that you're full-time, you know, you're anticipating that they're able to maybe see the bigger picture a little bit easier. You know, there's going to be a level of maturity there, a level of communication that may be a little bit different than, you know, some of your new to the workforce type of employees and your part-time staff. That's not always the case, but that's the general, you know, going into it, that's going to be the assumption. The other thing is I spend a lot of time and we spend a lot of time in discussion on succession planning and development, you know, and where do you want your career to go? You know, and we tell this to our entry level full time when they come in, especially working in the public sector, is this can be your career. You know, this can be what you do with your life. And it's a wonderful thing. And let me give you the benefits of that. And then let's talk it out on if this is something that you think you'd be interested in. If it is, what do we have to do to get you, you know, up the chain, if you will, or give you a better opportunity to be qualified to move up the ladder a little bit? Whereas on the part-time level, you're really honing in on, you know, like we mentioned, the skill development stuff, learning how to be a good employee. You know, especially we had so many employees here that are brand new to the workforce who don't understand, you know, the basic principles of punctuality and professionalism and you know, the value in a tucked in shirt, you know, that kind of stuff, that sometimes just needs to be reinforced on kind of a more of a micro level. So that development is honed in on there until, you know, they become a little bit more seasoned or they have the personality or the skill set that's going to work for a higher level type management role in the part-time ranks. And that's what we're really focusing a lot of attention with the part-time development and mentoring. Whereas, like I said, the full-time is, you know, not everybody wants to move up the ladder, but everybody should want to better themselves and play a part in bettering your organization. And so that's where we're really honing a lot of our efforts in on our full-time is their own personal development, but then also developing them to an extent that they're able to relate and groom and mentor their part-time employees to make them, you know, good representatives of the community, especially if you work in a public sector. You are obviously you're funded by the people you are serving in a lot of ways. Mm-hmm. So it's imperative that not only are we providing good service, but we're doing it, you know, in a way that would make the citizens proud that their tax dollars are going towards, that service and that employee. And so that's, I guess, in a nutshell, kind of where we focus our attention. But there is a difference, and it starts with, you know, just the way that we're communicating. But I will say, I think that that's overblown sometimes, and not to get too long-winded here, but, you know, a lot of times they do create this divide. It's like, okay, well, this is just the part-time employee, so this is about as much say as they're allowed to have. And this is the full-time employee, so since they're a full-time employee, they get to have all this other say and influence. And I don't really work like that. We've actually recently created something I call the Part-Time Advisory Council. So we have, you know, anywhere of 19 to 21 different areas or centers in our recreation division. And every one of those 19 to 21 areas now has a part-time representative on this council who are, they're hand-selected by the recreation manager over that division. They are there exclusively to work with me on what we can do to, you know, better the working environment for part-time employees, to ensure that part-time employees have a voice in the division, you know, and some of our best ideas were, sometimes you get to be a full-time employer, you get to be an administrator, and you get this, you know, this weird arrogance of, you know, my way or the highway, I've already done there, I've got all these great ideas. But the best ideas I've found come from the innovators, you know, and an innovator can be a 60-year-old or, you know, a 16-year-old, it doesn't matter. It's a mindset. So we're really pushing this part-time advisory council to come to the table with innovative ideas on things we can do differently across the board operationally, things we can do differently for their specific areas. You know, and without even knowing it, those part-time employees are being mentored and groomed on things like the proper way to conduct a meeting, the proper way to compromise, the proper way to hear no and move on to the next idea, you know, without holding a grudge, the proper way to implement ideas that are really good, and move it from the idea phase to the operational phase. So all those things, you know, are great. And I think that they're only going to help our department moving forward because it'll create that full buy-in culture, you know, and I use that opportunity to tell them things, you know, department updates, things coming down the pipe, things like that, that, you know, they're then responsible for relaying that to their fellow part-time coworkers, that maybe if we just did it the old-fashioned way of me sending out a memo and hoping that it trickled all the way down, wouldn't be nearly as effective. So that's proven effective so far, and I think it's going to do great things for us.
That's excellent. I really appreciate your outlook on that. You know, not looking at them as separate folks, but, you know, just like any individual, you know, that might need a little bit different type of attention, you know, they have a different type of attention that they need. And certainly, I think your process addresses the need to be heard, which I think can be something that is greatly overlooked when you look at people who are, you know, in a part-time type role. And some people even think, well, they're just here for the summer. You know, what possible input could they possibly have, you know? So I really appreciate what you have to say about that and how you run that.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, I think that, you know, it kind of goes to your, you know, your myth of the employee burnout. You know, it's not so much I've learned that employees are ever really burned out. It's just they're frustrated or they're, you know, it's what they don't feel like their input's going to be valuable. So I'll just come in, go about my business, and that's as valuable as I'm going to be. And, you know, it's our job from the part-time manager level all the way up to our director, all the way up to our city manager, to reinforce the value of every single employee that works for us. And it's a challenge when you're talking about, you know, thousands of employees in an organization. But it's one that I don't think anybody should shy away from. We should really tackle that head on and make sure that the newest hire to the most senior employee all feel that they're contributing to something that's better. So
absolutely. And if it were easy to do that, everybody would do it.
That's exactly right. Yeah. It's really easy to, you know, go into your burnout thing. It's really easy to just use burnout as an excuse or time as an excuse or whatever. And, you know, when it comes to developing your full-time and your part-time employees alike, your entire team, there is no excuse for not making that a priority. So
absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. Great. Thanks for watching this episode of Leader Tips Q&A. If you liked what you saw, go ahead and hit the subscribe button so you can be notified when new episodes come out. If you have a question for me, or if you'd have a question that you'd like to see addressed on a future episode, go ahead and put it in the comments. Thanks for watching.